So I believe the South Korean submarine military capabilities, there are certain sectors where South Korea is very strong, shipbuilding capacity, including submarine. So we expect that the shipbuilding and also submarine, 50 years ago you didn't have a proper defense industry, and now you have found the best defense industry. I am Dr. Ben Snemet from King's College London. I am an associate professor at the Defense Studies Department, and I mainly teach at the UK Defense Academy in Shrivenham. I'm also the executive director of the King's Center for Defense Economics and Management. So a few years ago, I started to check certain defense-related data, and I was surprised that the South Korean military, as large as the British, French, and German military combined, but South Korea spends much less on defense budget, and still the capabilities, the armor, combat power, and the readiness seems to be much higher than in many European countries. So I wanted to figure it out why this efficiency seems to be much higher in Korea than in UK or Germany or France. So if I am comparing South Korean defense industry to European defense industry, South Korea delivers weapon systems on time and on budget. And what we can see that European companies are really struggling to ramp up their capacities and delivering the weapon systems on time, and usually they are over budget as well. So there are several reasons for that. One reason is that countries, especially Europe and in the Middle East, but also in Asia, start to spend more on defense and want to buy more weapon systems. And there are very few countries that can deliver new high-quality weapon systems affordable in a very short period of time. So South Korea has an advantage in this way compared to many other countries. So today's event is impressive in many ways. Just reflecting on the other speakers, the quality of the lectures were very high level, so I want to engage with them and ask some questions or have conversations about that. And I also impressive the scale of the event. I was surprised how many people were in the audience in different rooms. So it's impressive in organizational ways and also in terms of the presentations. So my core message of the keynote speech is that oftentimes we see cooperation as a silver bullet. Cooperation is beneficial, but we need to be careful about how we analyze it. So I highlighted the trade-offs of cooperation. On the one hand, with defense cooperation, we can save money, and also we can get military benefits. But on the other hand, the trade-off is that multinational cooperation is often generates delays because of the more complex coordination, and it can generate also dependencies, which in this way we can lead to loss of autonomy. So my point is just be careful when you analyze cooperation. It's not everything is positive. You have to take into consideration the negative things as well, and then you will have a more realistic perspective about what you can expect. So in terms of submarines, there are so many different systems, subsystems that is needed to integrate into the submarines, that there are countries who are better in certain subsystems. So cooperation might be beneficial in terms of technology sharing and improving the capacities. And I think in this sense, cooperation can be very valuable if the countries and companies are making the necessary feasibility studies. So I believe the South Korean submarine military capabilities are among the best in the world, so there is no problem with the capabilities. But oftentimes, defense procurement is not only about capabilities, but also political alignments and different kind of policies that might change the winner. Even sometimes the best capability doesn't get the bid. So South Korea has to be careful also to make sure it understands the different political dynamics in their future export markets. So I believe the South Korean defense industry's prospects are pretty good, especially if we are looking at for the last few years, lots of successes happened in markets where South Korea didn't have much access before, like in Europe. We can see that many countries are going to spend even more on defense, especially Europe, Middle East, partially Asia. So there will be more countries who want to buy new weapon systems, and there are more demand, and South Korea will have more opportunities because it's already proved itself that it can deliver very high quality weapons on affordable price and on time. So what we can see that there are certain sectors where South Korea is very strong, It already proved itself in land systems. It has also great strengths in shipbuilding capacity, including submarine. So we expect that the shipbuilding and also submarine building will be one of the key areas. For instance, we know that many allies and partners are interested in South Korean shipbuilding. Even the US are considering to provide more role to the South Korean defense industry in terms of naval assets. So keep it up. I don't have any advice. You are doing great. So 50 years ago, you didn't have a proper defense industry, and now you have one of the best in the world. So just keep it up.